Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I have been buried up to my neck in Evernote for the past month and a half or 2 months as I've been putting on a Evernote webinar and a course on using Evernote. And I found three things in Evernote that I didn't know about that I thought were so cool, I wanted to share them with you. Are you up for it? Evernote uber cool ideas today on Dotto Tech. I have been, as I say, neck deep in Evernote for the better part of a couple of months now, as we just have completed a series of webinars showing people what Evernote is all about. And out of that, I also developed a 10-part course on Evernote. And when you dive in that deeply and you really spend a lot of time with apps, the cool thing is they surprise you. You find some things that you probably knew about, but you didn't know about. Do you know what I mean? And so I'm going to show you three tips or three little tricks that I found in Evernote that I thought were so cool that they should have some light shone on them. And so that's what we're going to do right now. Now, the first is, when you're working in Evernote notebooks, when you've got a collection of notes in a notebook, occasionally you're going to want to organize those notes and you're going to want to be able to, you want to basically create some sort of a table of contents because you want to know, you want a digest of what notes are in that notebook. And you can go through and I, in the past, would go type out what each note was and have a little, and have create a new note where I was writing down what all the other notes were. That is so old school and lame. Let me show you the way the cool kids on the block do this. I've got actually my entire course right here. So if you peek right now, you can see the course for free. All you do is you click multi-select all of the different notes in whatever you want to make this digest of, this table of contents. And that creates an option here for you to take all of the notes and merge them into a single note or save them as attachments. But the thing I want to show you is this one right here. It says create a table of contents note. Oh, don't keep your eye on this, because right underneath it, we're going to talk about the presentation side in a minute, because that was another really cool thing. All the cool things in this one menu. But create a table of contents note. Watch what happens when I click on it. It is a thing of beauty. It takes that entire note and it creates this table of contents. Now, it doesn't fill out all of the note information, but it does create hyperlinks to each and every note. So now we've got a table of contents that you can fill in more information in. But if you want to go to the fourth lesson, just click on the fourth lesson. It brings up that lesson. Isn't that cool? Creating a table of contents that quickly, that easily, from all of the notes in your notebook. Now, I should point out that you do have to logically name, like I numbered them all with the number at the beginning, because it's difficult to get the order correct without some sort of logical naming in the title that creates the structure that you need. But once you've got that structure in place, you can create a table of contents notes just like that. So cool. The next thing I wanted to show you is using Evernote for presentations. And this isn't something that you would typically think about. When you do presentations, you think Keynote or PowerPoint, you think high-end presentation packages. But that is a two-edged sword, because so many people, when they're making presentations and giving PowerPoint presentations, spend so much time and rely on the slides that they forget to present the information in any compelling fashion. They end up reading their slides and more caught up on the transitions. And then you spend more time on the format than you do on the content. And that's a shame. Now, it is important. I'm not saying it's not important to present your content in the best possible light. I believe that. But for some types of presentations, right out of Evernote, you can do a darn good job with its simple and elegant presentation capabilities. So when we're working in Evernote, when you're compiling your information in Evernote and you're writing a talk, if you use Evernote to deliver that talk, it's simple, it's clean, and information becomes king. It becomes the most important factor in presenting the information. Now, Evernote does not have a lot of fancy transitions. In fact, it has no transitions, but it does allow us to take the notes that we make, and as we create a document, it allows us to present it. And it's going to be ideal for small format presentations. You know, I'm not saying that I will use Evernote next time I'm giving a keynote talk to a major conference. Probably won't. But next time I'm talking to my team, or next time I'm talking to a small group of five or six people about a concept or a new idea that we're working on, and I've got a lot of research and notes in Evernote, that's the ideal time to use Evernote for doing presentations. And it gives you some really nice tools. Let me just show you how it kind of comes together. So you can present regular notes. You can present different format notes. Now, I've got here in my inbox, I've got a actually, this is a PDF version of the slideshow that I used in the webinar that I delivered about Evernote. So I'll use that as an example because it's prepared and it's simple, clean information as far as I'm concerned, formatted. So let me show you how you can present that in Evernote. So you can get into the presentation tool by going under the note menu, is it? Yeah, notes, and saying present, or you can just right click on the note here and say present. When I right click and say present, it converts immediately into full screen format. Now in this particular case, this is a PDF document, so it's a multi-page PDF, so I actually have to click on it in order to start it. If I was just in a note, I could scroll or work my way through the note. Now you can also present whole notebooks by using the arrow keys to jump from one note to the next and then the up and down arrows to scroll down within that note. But in this particular case, when I click here, it will launch full screen as if it's a slideshow, which it is, the PDF document that I saved all of my slides into. So here I've got my content ready to present. And if I hit the space bar, it moves from one slide to the next slide. Now, the interesting thing is there's a few extra tools. If we move our cursor up to the top, we see that we have a tool that will allow us to, they call it their laser pointer. So you can choose what color you want the pointer to be. You can choose blue or the pink that you have. So you can use that as you're working to highlight and to point out exactly what it is that you're talking about. Now, in this particular case, just hitting the space bar, I can move through my slides. But you can see there's no transition, there's no fancy dissolves, there's nothing like that. It's just the content. This is perfect for pure, simple content that you want to deliver elegantly and simply. So that is the concept of doing presentations in Evernote. And by the way, these tools also work in the mobility space. So both on the iPhone and on the Android phone, you can do presentations right from your phone to a projector, and you can give, again, this kind of simple presentation. It's not PowerPoint, it's not Keynote, but it is a tool that's going to allow you to present content. The last thing that I wanted to talk to you about today is completely in a different space, and that's talking about security using Evernote. And one of the questions that came up in every one of our webinars was people asked me how secure I thought Evernote was, because it's a cloud-based service where we've got our notes living on our computer, and then we sync them to our other devices, like our mobile devices or our notebooks or any other computers, through their cloud services. And the beauty of Evernote is having access to all of your information, all of your data, wherever you are. That's the strength. But there's the weakness there as well, because now if we've got it all synced, it means that we have a version of it living on the cloud. Just how secure is it on the cloud? And if you do have sensitive information on the internet, you are in your Evernote account, you have to think twice about whether or not you should be syncing that to the cloud, because you just don't know what could happen. So there are two levels of security that Evernote gives us. And this is actually probably an area that I think Evernote comes under the most criticism, and justifiably so, is because there should be a third and a fourth level of security, I believe. But the two levels that we have is, first of all, anytime that we create a notebook in Evernote, we can make it a local notebook. So see right here, we can say local notebook, meaning it's just going to be stored on our local system. It's not going to be synced to the internet. So as long as your local information is secure, your data should be safe. People can't just hack in. They can't access it through the web, for example, the way once it's stored on the cloud. Not that I'm expecting it could happen, but the potential of your information being compromised online. So anything that's of a sensitive nature, you might want to keep in a local notebook. What I can do is within a note, I can choose any section of text within that note. I can highlight it, right click on it, and I can choose to encrypt the selected text. When I do that, a dialog box pops up that allows me to put in an encryption passphrase. This is a password for the encryption, but this is something that you want to be very careful if you're going to do. While it will make that information virtually unhackable living online, it also makes it unrecoverable if you forget this password, because this isn't like a password to an account. Evernote doesn't have this information anywhere on their servers. The only place that this password will live is in your melon. So if you lose that information, then that content that's in that note can never be unencrypted, or because it's just brute force that will unencrypt it. There's no system in place to allow us to recover this passphrase, not password, but passphrase, should we lose it? And it doesn't work with any of our, at least it doesn't work with any of my password management tools. So you've got to be very, very careful about encrypting your notes this way in Evernote. And I'll editorialize here for a moment in Evernote. There's lots of conversation in the Evernote forums where people have been requesting this level of encryption to be extended beyond the note level. And this only works within a note. You can't encrypt an entire note this way unless you select all the text in the note to encrypt it. You can't automatically select an entire note and have it encrypted, nor can you select an entire notebook and have the entire notebook encrypted. And a lot of conversation is that that would be a feature that people think that they should have because they are entrusting so much information to Evernote. For now, it's not there. So we have to be very judicious about how we store information in Evernote. I hope that you found this video today to be useful. Three different features in Evernote that just blew me away that I didn't really hadn't really thought about much before I started preparing all of this information for the course. There are three ways for you to stay in touch with us if you want to kind of join the Dotto Tech community. The first is I ask you to subscribe to this channel, and that way you'll be notified of all our new videos as soon as they're released. You can also sign up for our newsletter. Then you'll get a weekly newsletter that will tell you about all of the new videos we create, as well as let you know about things like these webinars, which we produce on a regular basis. And finally, this is a community-funded channel through the crowdfunding site Patreon. If you want to know how to become a Dotto Tech supporter, where for as little as a dollar a month, you can ensure that I can continue to produce this kind of content, then I encourage you to visit my Patreon site and have a look. Till next time, have fun storming a castle.